Hey guys, welcome back. So I finally got my hands on the new Max Lens mod. To be honest, after the release of the Hero 9, I really didn't think it was going to be worth the upgrade from the Hero 8, but once I saw this lens mod, I was sold and immediately bought the 9. What I wasn't expecting was how hard it was to actually get my hands on the mod. After a few weeks, it became available, but sold out within hours. It's finally back in stock now. I finally got my hands on it. My buddy Byron also purchased one as well. What I found interesting was how hard it was for me to actually install it onto my camera. It just would not see all the way on, while Byron had absolutely no issues getting his on. So I did a little bit of research. Turns out there's a lot of people having the same exact problem. With some persistence, I was able to get mine on all the way, but it almost felt like I was going to break it. After I got it on, I took it on and off 3 or 4 more times and it did loosen up, and it does fit on just fine now. It's obviously just a really tight fit. For settings, I went with the max resolution, which is 2.7K, max superview, I use 24 frames per second, max hypersmooth on, and horizon lock on. For me, the idea of a gimbal-like camera with ease of use is exactly what I'm looking for. So let's get out on the trail and let's see what it's like. Byron found us a phenomenal new set of trails in our local area to test out the new mods. To my surprise, it was exactly what I was looking for MTB footage. It's like having a gimbal without that occasional lag and cornering. Not to say that the gimbal is dead by any means, there is still a major drawback for me, and that is that I personally like to use a chest mount. And if you're using a chest mount, if you stand up off your bike or thing over at the side, the only thing you're getting with the chest mount is a picture of the sky. So there is still that one awesome capability of having a gimbal, is it's always pointing in the direction you want it to. Here are the settings for the first test. Byron, who is recording on the side, is also using the same settings with his new Max Lens mod. For this run, the only setting we change is we put it on wide. Just for fun, I decided to turn off the max lens mod setting to see if I could use it like it was a 360 camera, but I'd say it's pretty obvious that's a solid no. I took the same footage, I applied some stabilization in Final Cut Pro, I keyframed the positions out, and obviously it's still terrible. But what can I say, I had to try it out. The rest of the testing I plan to do back at home. I have a decent berm to test out the horizon lock. We'll turn it on and off and see how it works and how if the stabilization is any different. Here is probably perfect to test out stabilization, so I figured we'll give this one a quick try. This time we'll do a full run, incorporating the drop over there on the left. In addition, I'm going to add the Hero 8 at the end so that you can get a comparison of all three possibilities. So far I'm liking the horizon lock a lot, but I do still kind of like the realism that you kind of obtain out of having the horizon lock off. So what do you guys think? Do you think this replaces a gimbal, and is it good enough for MTB footage? Leave a comment for which one you like the best. Thanks again for watching. I hope I've helped you in your opinion on whether or not you should add a max lens mod to your arsenal of camera gear. We'll see you next week.